Hello, welcome to my channel. Let's grow together. So today we have a topic called human circulatory system. So we all are aware of that this system is an internal transport of all the multicellular organisms, and it supplies nutrient and oxygen to all of the cells of the body and remove the waste product from them. So let us know in detail how this circulatory system actually work, on what process, what are the mechanisms take. So these are the circulatory system, the important process which takes place in the circulatory system. So the first point is importance of circulatory system. Why it is important? Why we have to know about our circulatory system? Because it performs two important functions. The first one is the removal of waste product and also distribution of food and oxygen to the body. So how this removal of waste product takes place? All the body cells need nutrient, oxygen, energy for performing circular activities, such as the metabolism of these nutrients, releases the carbon dioxide and ammonia. Both of them are toxic to our body, so it has to be removed immediately. And how this removal of waste product takes place? So that we are going to study. And then the next is the distribution of food and oxygen level. Okay, distribution of food and oxygen level. How this distribution takes place? In any unicellular or multicellular aquatic organism, cells receive nutrients and oxygen by direct diffusion from the surroundings. But in higher and complex organisms, substances cannot reach to every cell. In that condition, they need to be transported to the various body cells, thus result in the evolution of the circulatory system, where this play a significant role in distribution of oxygen and food. Important one is the component of circulatory system. What are the components which are involved in a circulatory system? As you can see in the slide, there's a blood, lymph and tissue fluid. These are the three components which are involved in circulatory system. This blood, lymph and even the tissue fluid, they carry the food and oxygen and the other substances to the body, and a system of blood vessels and lymph vessels to transport the body fluid that also help us to transfer the food and oxygen level. And the third is the main important organ, that is the pumping organ called as the heart, to pump the blood throughout these vessels and transferred. So this is how the importance of circulatory systems takes place, these three important products. So let us these three important points which are very necessary for to understand the process of circulatory system, how does it take place in our body. So let us go in detail one by one. Okay, as you can see here, this is the body. As you can see here, this is the blood, which we are going to study in details about the structure of blood, how this blood group is being differentiated, and why this blood clotting takes place, and what are these Rh factors in details. The body fluid in our body occur in following three forms, that is body lymph, blood, lymph and tissue fluid. As we all know, the blood circulates through the heart and blood vessels. Lymph, it flows through the lymph vessel and lymphatic organs. In the tissue fluid, these help the body cells, called intestinal fluid or the intercellular fluid, these are called. So let us go first to the blood, then we will followed by the lymph, and then the fluid tissue we are going to study. So the blood, how this blood is going to be characterized, what are the main functions of blood and what are its characteristics. Okay, blood is a bright red color fluid, flow through the heart and blood vessels. It function as distributing and collecting the medium. So what are the characteristics of this blood? Blood is thicker, heavier than water. Blood is slightly alkaline with the pH level between 7.3 and 7.45, and the blood volume in man varies from 5 to 6 liters. and blood forms 8 to 10% of the body mass, and blood is saltish in taste. Okay, so the next is the functions of blood. What are the main functions of blood? Blood help in transport of gases that carries the oxygen from the lungs to the tissue and carbon dioxide from the tissue to the lungs. Transports of food. It carries soluble and digested food like glucose, amino acids, fatty acids, etc. from the intestine to the various organs of the body. And the third, transport of excretory products, that is the nitrogenous waste, are transported by blood from tissue cells to the liver and from liver to the kidney, and from there they are eliminated out of the body in the form of urine. Then next is distribution of hormones. The endocrine gland secrete hormones such as thyroid gland, pancreas gland, pituitary gland, etc. are directly into the blood, and the blood help in transport of these hormones to the target organs and help in their chemical coordination. Next, defense against the diseases. It produces certain antibodies or antioxidants which combat the bacteria and neutralize their toxin white blood corpuscles and engulf the diseases causing bacteria and protects our body. Temperature regulation. The blood also help in absorbing heat production by respiration in the internal tissue and convey it to the oxygen and skin and lungs for dispersion into their air. Then maintenance of pH. The main product. Plasma protein of the blood act as a buffer and maintains the pH level of the body and the body fluid. The last one is the clotting. In case of injury and the rupture of blood vessels, blood clots on coming in contact with air and prevent the flow of blood from the wound. So these are the main functions of the blood. So let us study in detail about the structure of blood, that is the red blood corpuscles, white blood corpuscles and blood fluids. How are they look like?